Scotland's clubs seem further apart than ever in the fight to reshape the leagues. The latest attempt to get round the table has failed. And this week, Friday Sports Scene set out to discover why they can't agree. So where does the game go from here? Chick spoke to the man who has argued most strongly against the breakaway, Bill Hunter of Livingston, and on the other side to football's newest chairman, Bill Costley of Kilmarnock.
This is the story of two football club chairmen who view the breakaway from vastly different angles. On the one hand, Bill Costley, newly appointed head of the Kilmarnock board and successful Ayrshire hotelier and restaurateur. On the other, Bill Hunter, long-serving chairman of Livingston, nay Meadowbank Thistle, and a retired builder who isn't too interested in the reconstruction business, at least not the way the Premier Division clubs see it.
It's utter and sheer greed on behalf of the 10 clubs. I don't think for a minute that when they say that the extra money will make Scottish football a better product, I think they've got to prove that they can be a better product by producing the goods on the park and under the current setup. You've got teams that are playing Celtic and Rangers four times a year. Now, they are milking the cream off Scottish football. Now, I maintain that teams like St Mirren and Raith Rovers and Falkirk and Airdrie's, who are running full-time setups, should be encouraged to keep these full-time setups and make it a more competitive Premier League, thus bringing on youth policies as well.
I don't regard it as a breakaway. I see it as a progression, basically, of Scottish football. Outside the Old Firm, we've all got a common denominator in the respect that we're struggling financially. We have to try and address our financial problems so that it allows us to take our club and every club in the Premier League forward. The opportunity there is there for every club in Scotland to get the stadium in order, to invest. If geographically they're in a position to support the club, there's an open door there to get into the Premier League. And I think the ideal scenario is a larger Premier League than we've got at the moment, 12 or 14 clubs and perhaps even 16. I mean, that would be tremendous if we could do that.
So you're really wanting eventually, say, a 16 club Premier Division or call it what we will, First Division?
Yes, I think.
But is that not what they're saying will eventually evolve?
Well, they would start with they're saying it may evolve. There's no guarantee that it will evolve. If there's a guarantee in writing, an irrevocable mandate saying it will happen, then I would perhaps go along with it. But they're talking about 3 years before it would be increased to 16. Now, what's wrong, they can't implement that now. They would then be guaranteed to get in the First Division to vote their aims and proposals through at this stage.
Is this then really a make-or-break time for Scottish football?
I think it's a make-or-break time, yes. I think the initiative that's been shown, there's been a driving force in the Premier League, you know, to get change. It's changed in some respects, though, but I think realistically speaking, most people in Scotland, you know, are fed up with the standard of product that we are producing. And really, for us to produce, you know, competitive games week in, week out, we need to get that investment into the club. And we need to be in a situation where we are in control of our own destiny.
It's all very well saying we're in the top 10 to hell with everybody else. There was a lot of screaming and soul-searching 18 months ago when certain Premier League clubs were in the relegation spots. They were then screaming for a 16 league setup. So I'd like to know what's changed for 18 months ago with these clubs that are in there in that Premier League now. Why do they think at this stage that the four leagues of 10 is the best setup? I don't think that's the way to go forward, playing each club four times a year. It becomes boring.
It's not a negative step. It's just the beginning of a future that hopefully we'll be competing in the same level and confidently in Europe take the whole of Scottish football forward.